Antarctica in Snowboarding Bay, Penguin Ship Bay. So, smashing beers. Cheers, Dave.
Across the Drake. Ready to get on the smoke.
Across the Drake. Ready to go.
Got a little pimple up there.
This peak, that's where we're going tomorrow. We're going to reposition the boat around the other side of this glacier, and then we'll hike up from there and ski down the other side. If everybody had an ocean across the USA, then everybody'd be surfing like California. You'd see them wearing their baggies, Huarache sandals too, a bushy, bushy blonde hair.
We're waxing down our surfboard. We can't wait for June. We'll all be gone for the summer. We're on safari to stay. Tell the teacher we're serving USA. Hang your knees and fall
inside, outside, USA.
Pacific Palisade.
Let's take a tour of the boat. This is the helm, the outdoor latrine and slit trench at the back there. This is the greenhouse.
Isn't the greenhouse nice?
Remarkably warmer than out the back.
It's incredible.
Most of the time I watch.
Oh, what's Vicente doing?
Jeez. Let's go inside.
The pizza last night was
very small captain's cabin and bathroom in here. The watch roster, everyone does a 3-hour shift on the watch. Gina's just getting ready for that soon. So you gotta look at, when you're on watch, looking out for three main things: icebergs, storms, and whales. And anything else interesting?
No.
In here in the main sort of dining area, Bill peeling potatoes. Dave chopping onions. So he's not crying over our arrival in Antarctica. He's allegedly crying over the onions.
He's crying.
Down here is the navigational station, I guess you call it, or the office. GPS, phones, maps, captain's log.
Show them the pantry.
Sorry?
Show them the pantry.
The pantry's under here. All our food. There's no space wasted on here. Let's head through to the kitchen main living area. The heater, very important. Through here, the kitchen. Ashley in the kitchen where he belongs. One of the two girls on this trip, Ashley.
Rinsing a potato.
Oh. Then through here to the main living quarters. So there's four of us bunked up here. This is my space up here.
Not a lot of room.
Here's some of the ridiculous amounts of gear we've bought. All the skis are stored underneath at the back. We'll get them out in a day or so when we start heading out up into the mountains. Cool.
Okay, so we just recovered from an avalanche, which was fun. We're attempting to get to the top of this peak over here. We're literally just at the top of those rocks on the left. Damien was in the lead, Ash was second, I was third on the rope. It was pretty slow and slushy at the top. We're not that far above sea level, only 200 meters. I was third, took one step, mountain gave way. I went down, started yelling. The other guys noted as well. Tried to hold it. Ash couldn't hold it, he came with me, and then with the momentum of me and Ash falling, Damien came with us as well. I ended up against a rock trying to hold it. Didn't quite hold it, and then that pulled me around the rock. That's led to bump my elbow, nice gash on the pant and the leg. Little short bruise up nice and well. And a couple other scratches and bruises here and there. But apart from that, we're all right. So we end up at the bottom of the avalanche. No one was buried. It wasn't terribly thick, but it's just old, wet, slushy, shitty snow, and it gave way.
It's a tale of survival.
It's a tale of survival. Here's a bird that's coming to the mountain.
Fighting dragons around the mountain. I nearly lost a nut.
I'm pretty sure we'll get a movie deal out of that. We would have slid at least 100 meters.
So I started writing my book.
Yeah. So those of you watching that might comment and say that we should have stayed roped, we didn't, because we're just near these rocks. And I need to get a better look at my leg and everything, which we didn't want to faff around on the mountain too long.
If you are watching this now, it means we have been avalanched.
If this tape survives and we don't, hi mum, and hi Mrs. Ashley's mum, and hi to Damo's wife and mum. Bye.